Hi guys, it's Future Sarah speaking. This vlog is what I did in Beijing between August 19th and the 22nd. I just filmed clips here and there as I thought to, and I put them together, and I'll be doing a voiceover like I have the previous vlogs that I posted. So here we go. Best. This was us walking to the grocery store in the morning. It's a smaller one that we haven't really been to, but we primarily go here to buy eggs. It's called Mai Guo Guo, and it's typically a really small store with a lot of people. So this is the front of the store. I really like how it's bright and yellow and white. There was a lot of people, as you can tell. This was us walking back.
There's lunch.
That previous clip was us on the bus, and then now this one is us on the subway. The subway system is really extensive in China, and it's really nice to be able to get to where you want to go. This was the subway. It wasn't that packed, but I would say this is like medium level of busyness. This is inside the subway station. It's really clean and it's nice and pristine. I saw minions there, so I had to take a picture for my little nephew. And this is the mall that we ended up going to. The bus and the subway, and then we arrived at this mall. I was fascinated by all of the little frozen desserts they had. My dad tried out the massage chairs and he approves. And then there was, on the basement level, there was a lot of food court style. There was the desserts I showed you earlier, and now there was these people making dumplings live. And I thought it was really cool. I sped up the video, but they were really fast. There was also a little cake shop with really decorative cakes. And the same shop had bread also, and it smelled amazing in there. This was the mall. It was, I think, 7 floors. There's 2 floors of food courts. I thought this was a nice photo op, and I made my dad sit next to me and take a photo as well. There was dancing on the 4th floor, I believe, before. And this was one of the statues outside the store, a spa, and I thought it was interesting. I also thought this was interesting, that there was watermelons with faces on them. This was Baby Yang Qishui, which was one of my favorite things to drink. And I had to take a picture by the logo. It's like a polar bear. It's a kind of like orange soda, but it's so much better than that. My dad, they also have different flavors and like food now. They used to just be popsicle, or it used to just be like a drink, but now there's popsicles as well. We stopped by another store on the way back, and I was amazed by all the little treats.
I got to show you guys what we had for dinner, but it was so good. It was like tofu strips, tofu sirt, and cucumber, and we also had like a lettuce vegetable, and then we had leftovers, shredded potatoes and bell peppers and some soup. So it was really good. And now I'm really tired and I'm just laying on the couch and I'm watching TV, and I'm waiting for my grandma to come start her TV show at 7:30. It's currently 7:15, and then when she comes and sits and watches, I'll probably go watch my own YouTube, because I don't really like the TV show. But the news is interesting always.
Breakfast. This is one of my grandma's friends. She lives across the hall. And I thought it was cute that we took a picture together. This was me pushing my grandma to get my ID, and we walked along this pretty busy street, but it was a straight way. This is a trash collection stop that they have. They will basically buy your trash and in turn give you money for it, which I thought was pretty cool. My grandma pushed her own wheelchair on the way back from Ume to our house, which is pretty far. We took a selfie together. She really wanted to take a picture together.
Look at all the air conditioning.
Lunchtime.
I helped my grandma install a new shower, like, handle thing. We went to Ume to go get some vegetables and some pears, and I was, of course, amazed by all of the snacks again. They call it dried food there, but it was basically, there was mochi, there was, like, bars, there was fruit, little pouch fruit jellies. There was like tofu, there was bread, there was like a lot of different things. And of course, this is my favorite. I didn't get any, I ended up getting it on Taobao.
I just went to fill up the water jug and I'm bringing it home. It's very heavy. Yay. Breakfast.
This is the best thing that has ever existed.
We went to another grocery store. And we go to a lot of grocery stores basically every day because it's very convenient and you don't have to drive a car and make like one big trip every week. So it's very common for people to go every single morning or in the afternoon to a grocery store. So this was us browsing. We were going here to get some breakfast items and also some vegetables. This was me checking on the chickens. They were about to go to bed because it was like the daytime where we were, so it was nighttime for them. They're preening. Back to the grocery store. We packaged our own items into our own basket, and then this is the exchange for our basket to our own little cart that we brought. And then we loaded it up into our own cart, and then we went upstairs.
Repel the mosquitoes.
This is my grandma going on her morning walk. And after her walk, she decided to sit in the sun with the neighbor from across the hall. They were really cute together. This was four of them, but three of my grandma's friends all together, and they were sitting under this little shade. They were hanging peppers to dry from like the roof of the little tent. This was mail that we were getting, a package, and it was coming to the P.O. box. And every single time we got like the 6 or 8 digit code for us to pick up. I tried on my swimsuit, which is what had come in the mail. And then I also had to go pick up some desserts that my aunt bought that were also in the mail later in the day. So two trips to the P.O. box.
Snack time.
Three trips. This was something my friend bought that she wanted me to bring back to the U.S. So. My dad and I helped my grandma cut this long piece of wire that was hanging down from our floor.
Breakfast!
This is the best breakfast item ever, shaobing. I could eat a million of them, but this is my favorite thing to eat when I get back to China for breakfast in the morning. This was my chickens. I was checking on them. They were all nestled up and sleeping.
I'm starting off the morning by picking up some packages. I, to be honest, don't know what's in them, and I guess I'll figure it out when I get home. They're doing some paving around here, so they just paved this road,
which is very much needed. Construction in our little neighborhood, so this was very loud. I'll spare your ears. I'd also got my swim cap and goggles.
I got my swim cap and my goggles. Picked them up. It was in this package. The other package was an egg holder.
This is the egg holder. You pull out the front egg and all the eggs come. It's like in a little cycle if you want to like use them.
Very cool.
Morning walks.
Great snack. Highly recommend.
This is lunch.
Yummy, yummy, yummy. Look, guys taking all the equivalent of blue bikes and putting them here. Riding the bus to the mall. We're waiting for the bus. It's our bus.
I wanted to video the views from the bus, so this is kind of a montage video of the different things that we passed by on the bus on the way to the mall. Similar to the blue bikes in Boston, they have these yellow, green bikes for rent that you can use with a QR code. There's a lot of people using those motorbikes and also just the regular QR code bikes too. I thought this building was interesting when we passed by. Interesting architecture for sure. This was us approaching the mall that we were going to be going to. That entire orange building is the mall, and it stretches for what seems like infinite length. We didn't even get to go through all of the mall, but we went to like maybe a fourth of it. But it's really big and amazing, a feat. There's a directory for what is on the different floors, and you can see by the amount of shops that there are that it's crazy big. This was a fun play place on the first floor when we first walked in that I was impressed by. This is the name of the mall. It was at the very front, and I took a picture with the little bear behind all those flowers. I'm pretty sure someone left that there, but my dad said it's for decor. There's the croc shop. These are all the widgets. There's like even an arcade place. There was multiple of these. My dad went to go look at counters for my grandma, so there was that. This was the construction part of the mall, and it was already this big, so it's actually a separate building than the original mall. This was a shoe place. We walked by like an insane amount of shoes. I thought it was funny. This was With Wheat, which is kind of the equivalent of When Pigs Fly in China. It's like a bakery bread shop, and we ended up picking these two pieces of bread, loaves for my grandma, and both of them were really good. This was me with the bread bag in front of the mall. This is their school bus. I thought it was very cute and little. And this was some of the traffic that we drove by. We left the mall right around 5 o'clock, which was a pretty bad idea, but this was stop and go in traffic for what seemed like forever. So enjoy the traffic. It's future Sarah again. I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. More to come of my adventures in China. I just wanted to close it out because it ended abruptly with, this is what I had for dinner, and I never finished it. So hope you guys enjoyed.